Now moving to the second part of property number 6, we are having tan inverse x minus tan inverse y is equal to tan inverse x minus y upon 1 plus xy, where xy is greater than minus 1. Okay. So earlier we were having tan inverse x plus tan inverse y is equal to tan inverse x plus y upon 1 minus xy. So same thing we are using, let tan inverse x equal to a, tan inverse y is equal to b. X is equal to tan a, y is equal to tan b, a b belongs to minus pi by 2 comma pi by 2. Now here we are having tan a minus b is equal to, what was the formula what you did in class 11th? Now the formula was tan a minus tan b upon 1 plus tan a tan b. Similarly, here also we are getting this one like this. And now what about our condition? Now the condition was here xy is greater than minus 1, here it is, xy is greater than minus 1, so 1 plus xy is greater than 0. So now we are having this thing, basic thing, okay. So now what condition arises? Now here we are having number 1, it is x is greater than 0, y is greater than 0. Number 2, x is greater than 0, y is less than 0. X is less than 0, y is greater than 0, and x is less than 0, y is less than 0. Now here why I have written 4 different, because we have to prove now for the subtraction part, for the difference part. So there will be a little bit difference between second and third. Okay, earlier, because there we have to add it in the first part, this part what we did, a plus b or b plus a, this was one and the same thing. Okay, even we can write it a plus b is equal to b plus a. So always we were using tan inverse x plus y. Now here we can't write it a minus b is equal to b minus a, so this is wrong. Okay, so we can't write like this. Okay, so this is not equal to b minus a, so that's why I have done separately second and third part. Okay, so now let's start with the first part as we have done in the, sorry, let's start with the first condition as we have done in the part number 1. Now case 1, let x is greater than 0, y is greater than 0, then x, when x is greater than 0, what we did in the last class, I am just writing on this side because there we have written a formula. Now it was, when x is greater than 0, we are having 0 is less than a is less than pi by 2, condition number 1, where a belongs to, here 0 comma pi by 2, you can write it, a belongs to 0 comma pi by 2. Now when y is greater than 0, we are having 0 is less than b is less than pi by 2. Now here what I want a minus b. Okay, so now let's do some a little bit inequality problem. We are having 4 is less than 5, we are having 4 is less than 5. Now what we are doing, suppose we are having 4x is equal to 24. Here it is equal to, here it is less than, or you can write it greater than. Now if we suppose we have to put it minus 4x is equal to minus 24, it doesn't matter any, because there is equal to, and we have done for this equation part, whatever changes we have done for both the sides. But can you do here for both the sides? Can I write like this, minus 4 is less than minus 5? It becomes wrong. Minus 4 is what? Minus 4 is greater than minus 5. Okay, so this is basically wrong, this is right. So while doing the inequality, when we are changing the sign, we have to change the inequality also. Okay, so this was some little bit basic thing which you have already done in the earlier classes. So now I want here a minus b. I want what? A minus b. Okay, so for a minus b, here it should be minus. So I am not writing minus multiplying these three by minus, minus and minus, but we are actually getting the same thing. Now what should I do here? Then I will be writing 0 is less than minus b is less than minus pi by 2. Sorry, 0 is greater than minus b is greater than minus pi by 2. And finally, what this becomes? Finally, it becomes minus pi by 2 is less than minus b is less than 0. Okay. So, now we are going for this part. This is first and this is the second part. Okay. So, now adding 1 and 2. Adding 1 and adding 2. What we are getting? 0 plus minus pi by 2 is less than a minus b is less than, here it is pi by 2, pi by 2 plus 0. So, what finally we got it? We get it minus pi by 2, 0 plus minus pi by 2 is minus pi by 2 is less than a minus b is less than 0. So, this is the condition what we get it. You can just check it. It is pi by 2. 0 is less than minus pi by 2 is less than a minus b is less than pi by 2. Now, let me write the condition here. For this part, let me write it. I am not writing here. I will be writing here. What was the condition? Condition for number 1. And number 1 is what? This one. Okay. It is minus pi by 2 is less than a minus b is less than pi by 2. Why I have written like this? Just to show you, just to compare the things. Okay. So, now we are getting tan a minus b is equal to x minus y upon 1 plus xy, and a minus b is equal to tan inverse x minus y upon 1 plus xy, and a is what? Tan inverse x, tan inverse y. So, we are getting tan inverse x minus tan inverse y is equal to tan inverse x minus y upon 1 plus xy. So, here the result is for the first part. Okay. Now, let's move for the case 2. Because now we are having 4 cases. So, let's move with case 2, case 3 and then case 4. Now, for case 2, we are having case 2. For case 2, we are having x is greater than 0 and y is less than 0 here. X is greater than 0, y is less than 0. Same conditions, okay? Now, I will be writing the conditions and then finally, we are going to approach for the final step. Now, here what is? When x is greater than 0, we are having 0 is less than a is less than pi by 2. And when y is less than 0, what we are having? Minus pi by 2 is less than b is less than 0. Again, what we want? We want here minus b. So, this becomes now when I am changing the signs minus minus minus, then what we are having? Pi by 2 is greater than minus b is greater than 0. And now you can write it when y is less than 0, then what originally, what finally we are getting? This part we are getting 0 is less than minus b is less than pi by 2. Okay. So, now adding these two, first and second. Adding 1 and 2, what we get? 0 plus 0, 0 is less than a minus b is less than, now pi by 2 plus pi by 2. Pi by 2 plus pi by 2. So, we are having 0 is less than a minus b is less than pi. So, for this part, we are having a new condition, that is 0 is less than minus 0 is less than a minus b is less than pi. So, for condition 2, now I am writing, we are having 0 to pi by 2. 0 is less than a minus b is less than pi. Just to check the difference, what we are getting. Okay. So, now what to do it for this part? Now, what we are having? Can we write like this? X plus minus y here, because we are adding it in the first step also, we got it x plus y. So, we are having x minus y to x minus y. We can write it x plus minus y is greater than 0 and 1 plus xy is greater than 0, and this implies x minus y upon 1 plus xy is greater than 0. Okay. So when it is greater than 0, now easily we can solve it. We are having tan a minus b is equal to x minus y upon 1 plus xy. Further, this step we are going to do in the final stage, because already I have shown you that after this one we are getting this thing and then we are getting this property. Okay, I will be showing you. So this was basically case 2, what we have done it. Now let's start with case 3. For case 3, you will be just, that's why I have written here, I have written here the situations what we are getting, the results what we are getting. So for now case 3, now case 3 is what we are having. For case 3, it is x is less than 0, y is greater than 0. Now when x is less than 0, we are having minus pi by 2 is less than a is less than 0. When y is greater than 0, that you did it in the first part, when y is greater than 0 here. So what we wrote it, when y is 0 greater than 0, 0 is less than b is less than pi by 2. Now again changing here from positive b to negative b, because what we wanted, we want angle as a minus b. So again let me change the signs. So here becomes 0, and I am not writing negative of 0 because 0 is only 0. So don't be confused that why sir has not written negative 0. Okay. So 0 is greater than minus b is greater than minus pi by 2, and finally we get it minus pi by 2 is less than minus b is less than 0. Okay. Now again adding 1 and 2. Adding 1 and adding 2. So what we get it? Minus pi by 2 plus minus pi by 2 is less than a minus b. I have used adding, so here also we can write it a, you can write it a plus minus b, write this thing. Okay, so and this seems to be, when we are solving, oh let it be like this only, and it is, then a is 0 and here it is also 0, 0 plus 0. So we are getting it minus pi by 2 minus pi by 2, minus pi by 2 minus pi by 2 is less than a minus b is less than 0. And what we are getting, we got minus pi by 2 minus pi by 2 is minus pi, minus pi is less than a minus b is less than 0. So here we are getting this condition. Let me write it for number 3. We are having minus pi, minus pi is less than a minus b is less than 0. Now see how changes we are getting. Second and third, what are the changes here? Okay, so minus pi is less than a minus b is less than 0. Now here we can write it again one and the same thing, that x minus y is equal to x plus minus y is less than 0, and 1 plus xy is greater than 0, and this implies tan a minus b is equal to x minus y upon 1 plus xy. Okay, so why we are solving this one, why we are proving this thing? Never we got a question in the board exams to prove this thing, but what sometimes we think there can be a question like this, so you should be knowing how to prove it. So this was case third, and finally approaching to case 4, we are getting now case 4. What is case 4? X is less than 0 and y is less than 0. Now again simple, x is less than 0, it means what? Minus pi by 2 is less than a is less than 0. When y is less than 0, again minus pi by 2 is less than a is less than, sorry, is less than b is less than 0. Now adding 1 and 2, what we get it? Minus pi by 2 plus minus pi by 2. I'm sorry, I have to change this as a negative also. So this becomes, now changing these symbols, we are getting minus pi by 2 is greater than minus b is greater than 0. or we can write it 0 is less than minus b is less than pi by 2. Minus into minus becomes plus, so we are getting pi by 2. Now this is not second, this is the second. Now adding first and adding second, what we are getting? We are getting minus pi by 2 is less than a minus b is less than pi by 2. Let me write it for condition number 4. We are having minus pi by 2 is less than a minus b is less than pi by 2. Now do you remember? This is the same thing what we get in the part 1. Okay. So now after writing all these things, what we get? Finally, you have, I wrote right in the beginning in the first step also. Now this implies that tan a minus b is equal to x minus y upon 1 plus xy, and a minus b is equal to tan inverse x minus y upon 1 plus xy. And what is a? Tan inverse x. Tan inverse x minus tan inverse y is equal to tan inverse x minus y upon 1 plus xy, where xy is greater than minus 1. Now for all these conditions, now let's check it. For what was the condition number 1? Then number 2, then number 3, and then again we are getting with number 4. So these were the conditions for second part. Okay. So now after doing this, I am going to show you the formulas, extended formulas for the competition part, and you are just going to look the formulas, and then we are going to solve some very nice questions based on these properties.